Michael Luke has been in touch to ask how to paint the energy orbs that appear on top of a void shield generator. So in this video, we're going to show you a great way to get a cool lightning effect for them. Now to do it, what you need to do first of all is stipple with Cantor Blue and then shade all over this using Norn Oil. After that, we're going back to Cantor Blue for another coat of stippling it and then do the same with Xerius Purple. After that, we're ready to paint the lightning using Lothan Blue first of all and then a small amount of White Scar. So starting out then with Cantor Blue, now to stipple what you need is a small dry brush and you just start out as if you were going to dry brush with the paint. So start working the paint in amongst the bristles of your brush there like that. But you don't have to go quite so far in it, you want to keep the paint still fairly wet. And what you do is just get hold of the area you're going to paint and you just start stabbing the brush onto it there like that to get a random pattern building up. Now I'm just going to concentrate on this one orb, but you want to do the same thing on all four. Next apply a coat of Norn Oil all over the orb to darken down the blue. Once the shade's completely dry, we're going back to Cantor Blue to stipple it on again, but this time don't do it all over the orb, instead just do it in smaller clouds, just randomly across the surface of it. Then do the same thing using Xerius Purple, so once again small random clouds across the surface of the orb. With that done, we're now ready to start painting in the lightning, and for this you need Lothurn Blue first of all, applied with a small airbrush, and what you do is paint short, straight lines emanating from these round devices on the side of the orb and just have them going randomly across the surface of it. And then trace over some parts of the lightning using White Scar just to finish off this detail. And there we are, the effect is complete, and if you wanted to, you could paint over this with Ard Coat to give it a glassy finish to it. But whether you do or not, of course, it's entirely up to you. So Michael, I hope that helps you out painting your scenery and that you get a really cool effect with it, and we'll see you all again very soon.